Hello, my name is Marie-Thérèse van Kessel. I'm an engineer at Huesker Synthetic, and I would like to introduce you to building with geosynthetic reinforced soil. This method of construction makes it possible to construct foundations, slopes to build steep embankments, and construct vertical retaining walls. Before we take a look at the diverse range of possible applications, let's first get to know the underlying soil mechanics and technical principles involved in the design and calculation. Geosynthetic reinforced soil is a composite body composed of granular soil and reinforcing elements made of polymeric materials called geosynthetics or geotextiles. The geosynthetics are incorporated into the soil in individual horizontal layers that can be spaced above each other vertically. This results in a composite wall that absorbs and transfers inherent and dynamic loads and the lateral earth pressure of any unreinforced backfill soil. Selecting high-quality building materials and a precise calculation method are important factors for the performance of geosynthetic reinforced soil, as is careful construction. The system's mechanism of action is based on the bond behavior of the backfill soil and the geosynthetic reinforcement. If the shear strength of the soil is exceeded, a sliding wedge is formed in the active area. In this area, friction and interlocking, known as bond behavior, initiate loads in the reinforcing element. From there, the loads are transmitted to the stable or passive zone. This means that if the bond behavior is favorable, the deficit of forces is compensated by the tensile strength of the geosynthetic reinforcements and structural integrity is maintained. The second edition of Recommendations for the Construction and Calculation of Earth Bodies with Geosynthetic Reinforcements was published in Germany in 2010. Along with other applications of geosynthetics in geotechnics, the book defines and explains the construction and calculation with geosynthetic reinforced soil. The required number, tensile strength and length of the reinforcing elements are calculated in one step, which also determines the safety against fracture or against the reinforcement from pulling out. To verify the safety of the embankment, all possible sliding surfaces must be investigated. On the one hand, these include sliding surfaces that intersect reinforcing elements, lying completely within the reinforced earth body or projecting beyond it through the backfill soil. On the other hand, sliding surfaces are also analysed that completely surround the reinforced soil body without intersecting a reinforcement layer. The internal stability of geosynthetic reinforced soil is determined to a great extent by the shear parameters of the fill material and by the tensile strength, length and arrangement of the geosynthetic reinforcement. The most important influence parameters in the verification of global stability are the external loads and the mechanical properties of the backfill soil and the subsoil. In addition, the design is analysed with respect to safety against ground seepage, sliding and bearing capacity. To protect the geosynthetics from UV radiation, vandalism or fire in the front of slopes formed of geosynthetic reinforced soil, they are provided with a facing. Design possibilities range from planting via gabion systems to stone blocks or vertical concrete elements. There are facing systems that are actively involved in transferring the load of the overall system, thus performing a static function. But there are also facing systems that do not play an active role in load transfer. In both cases, the safety of the facing elements and the safety and durability of the bond between the geosynthetic reinforcement and the facing elements, if applicable, has been well documented. The application areas of geosynthetic reinforced soil encompass not only simple structure, such as sound barriers, but also things like road embankments and even highly sensitive structures like bridge abutments or railway embankments. Its applicability has been tested and confirmed in large-scale trials and test walls, as well as a number of successfully completed construction projects. Geosynthetic reinforced soil is being chosen more and more often as a cost-efficient alternative to standard methods of construction. In some countries, in the Netherlands, for example, Geosynthetic reinforced soil has already become a standard construction method in its own right. The reason for this is the method's superior adaptability to project-specific requirements. These can include, among other things, the type of load transfer, geometry, and construction time. Even artistic facets can be addressed by a free choice of geometry, form, and facing. I hope that you found this presentation interesting. Should you be interested in further technical details on Huesker solutions, please visit us at our website or feel free to contact us in person.